Immutable backups are more important than ever. One of the easiest ways to do that is the Veeam Hardened Repository. This is a very attractive way to have immutable backups on premises on Linux file systems with no additional Veeam cost. Now, I know not all of you are Linux experts, but trust me, this is not a very difficult process to set up. Let me take you into the lab and walk you through this just now. So what I'm looking at here is Help Center. That's our Veeam documentation site, and it's really, really good. So I highly recommend you start here. There's a dedicated section just on the Hardened Repository. This will walk you through a lot of installation options as well as post-installation configuration. I want to draw your attention to the post-installation section because I have already installed Linux, and I'm going to do these few but necessary commands right here. So I have an SSH session open to my Linux system, and let's go ahead and do these directory ownership and then access configurations right here. So let's type in these commands really just as they are. And I have put the hardened repository in the mount path /VHR, Veeam Hardened Repository. That's a dedicated drive just for the Veeam backups. Now let's roll in this command here, changing ownership to the VHR admin account for the path of VHR. And during the installation, you can set this up. This is an elevated command. I'm going to drop in the credential. And then the second command, I'm going to change this mode for the owner as well. Here we go, 700 for /VHR. Sudo command as well. Yep, you can see both of these essential steps here. This will be very important for you to use this VHR going forward. And then really everything is in Veeam backup and replication after that. So let's add a backup repository. Now the VHR, the hardened repository, categorically, it's direct attached storage. It's file system space on a Linux system that will be holding these immutable backups. I highly recommend the hardened repository guided wizard where you can build this knowing that immutability is on by default. Let's start with a name. I'm going to call it VHR Linux, but it tells me it's hardened and it's Linux. I'm going to add a new system here because I just made that system I showed you. I am using the DNS name. IP works as well, but I'm going to use the DNS name here. And you can see it's Rick's VHR04. And I've got the full name there. Highly recommend using the single use credentials. This is really for the guided wizard, the only way to do it. And this really lets the Veeam BNR server not have a persistent connection back to the VHR. So let's put in that credential right here. And when we do this, by the way, this will, in the first time it's going to connect through SSH, definitely recommend checking out the documentation for all these requirements in Linux, but it's going to push out the installer and transport services. So right here, it's pushing out those services to that Linux system. And then once those single use credentials are done to do that, the VHR communicates back with the Veeam server. It's a really good architecture. Again, check out the documentation so you can see how that works. But basically then this server will be inventoried and ready to go amongst the other backup repositories. Now, if I remember correctly on this system, the /VHR path, which we'll see right here, is a 10 terabyte volume. Of course, you know, you might have larger, but this is a lab. But you definitely want to have the VHR in a path that has the most amount of space. So I've made /VHR. We'll go ahead and populate it here in a moment. But one thing I want to highlight is that the fast cloning on the XFS file system will give you a spaceless full backup technology. It's not deduplication, but it prevents duplication. And then also 7 days base immutability. You cannot go lower than that, by the way. There it is, 10 terabytes. And so when you're building the VHR, this right here, checking the XFS fast clone requirements is really important, as well as the apply step. And I'll talk about that in a second. These defaults are really good, especially if you're going to use Veeam Instant Recovery. Veeam Instant Recovery is really helpful for that high-speed recovery technique, and it's configured right here. Now, these services on the mount server will already be in play, but if you wanted to, you could import the backups on that VHR. And so right here, these steps are super important because it verifies that the backup repository is going to function as you would expect. And then when this is done, this is inventoried and ready to go in your Veeam server, and you can start putting backups on this VHR right away. So just like that, the VHR is actually relatively easy to configure. I do recommend you check out both the Help Center documentation at helpcenter.veeam.com, and we have a couple of additional resources on our community hub. I've got the link right here, where you can also see some of the latest updates that we do around our Veeam On event, especially around some automated configuration. Now, all of this starts with a really powerful platform, the Veeam Data Platform. You can go and download a trial at veeam.com today. Do that, let us know. Also on this channel, let us know what additional videos you want to see. Like, subscribe, comment, just let us know what you want. But regardless, it all starts at veeam.com. We'll see you there.